I'm sorry, Meadow Shiori, I'm not about to give you another game here. Oh, okay, well, I'm getting a challenge from a GM here, from Ginger GM, which, if I'm not very much mistaken, is English Grandmaster Simon Williams. Even though he seems to be rated quite low here, if it's the guy that I'm thinking of, and by 2e4 sacrificing the pawn, I'm pretty certain it is, I could be in some trouble here. So I'm going to try and commentate over this game as I probably get horribly crushed by Simon. So I have to be careful of Queen h5 check in this position, so I'm going to go Knight f6. And I know Simon, he wants to be a pawn down. I'm not going to let him. There you go, Simon, keep your material. I am not taking that off. Now, I think this is the first... This might be the first GM that I've played in Hack Attack. So let's see how this goes. Don't have a lot of experience of giving Grandmasters the odds of trying to commentate on the game whilst playing against them, but you know, Simon will probably be doing some other things as well. So he's got h3 to cover bishop g4. I'll try to get back to commentating a bit more about the actual position in this game. I could play knight g4 here and maybe win some material, or knight d4 and c6 and b5. Goes against every principle that I have to play knight g4 and grab the material. Plus, there seem to be some annoying tactics based on h7. So I just don't really want to do that. I want to go c6 and b5. I'm happy to win material that way. But I'm trying to keep some kind of control over the game. And he obviously doesn't want to let me do that. a4, I'll just go a6. How are you going to stop me from playing b5? That is the question. Now, this is quite exciting, actually. It's nice to be playing such a strong player in this Hack Attack broadcast for twitch.tv. I don't know if this is the first GM that would have been playing in a live broadcast over on Twitch TV. But at the moment, it is all going according to plan. I think I'm picking up this pawn on e4. And my pieces are on lovely, fantastic squares. But the one thing you can never afford to do when playing a Grandmaster is to relax and think you've won the game. You know, if it play against a lower rated opponent, I might go, well, and you know, if I don't blunder hideously, then the game is won. But against such a talented player as Simon, there's every chance that he can get his way back into the game. I mean, I should be clear here, if I play well and look after my pieces, I should win this game. I'm a touch behind on the clock, but the exchange and a pawn is what I have extra here. I want to go bishop a1 and e4 and bishop b2, mate. Oh wow, can he really do that? I guess he'd know, but this feels very, very risky. I'm trying to play very, very quickly here, because I know that my opponent's going to be constantly going for tricks, and I'm going to need every second in order to combat those tricks. Oh, no, 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 no. Ooh, I almost played an awful pre-move there. Oh, and I've just given away a piece. Oh, I completely distracted myself and lost my concentration. That's really frustrating. Oh, I've blown it. Not good at all. Not good at all. Because I was material up, the game isn't over. There's actually some chance of a comeback here. But it's gone from completely winning for black to probably winning for white. my chances are tied to this passed e-pawn, and I just don't think I have enough. Slightly surprised by b5, getting pawns pushing everywhere now. Coming back into the game just a little bit here. Need to get connected past pawns pushing down the board. Of course, my opponent has pawns as well. He lets that go. Maybe he's hoping that when his pawn gets to b7, it's going to be all over here. More likely, I don't know. I don't know. I should be winning here, but it's so complicated with the presence of that pawn on b7 that I don't want to call it. I need to get my own d-pawn pushing, and I need to get it pushing fast. This is quite tense actually now. Give a little check there and then here. Oh, and it's going to go a6. Oh no. I don't see what I'm going to do. Oh, it's going to be all over. But I am up on the clock, so I'm going to try and shamelessly flag my grandmaster opponent here. Because, you know, there's no such thing as... there's no such thing as a bad win in bullet chess or blitz chess. Sorry about that, Simon.
Do you have Simon on Skype?
So I'm just apologising to him in chat. Yeah. Let's see if he'll go for a rematch. Okay. Well, let's jump back into another game there and see what happens. An odd finish to that game. Simon knows that it'll be embarrassing for me to lose to this kind of... Oh, no. This is not how I want this to go at all.
Oh, dear.
I'm just speechless. Struggling for the words. This isn't the best way of taking advantage of one g5 either. But, I don't know. It's cruel of Simon to play this way because no one wants to be broadcasting live and lose a game to g5. I've got, unsurprisingly, I've got a good opening position here. But if... Based on the last game, the opening is not what's going to decide this one. He's offered me a draw. What a nice guy. What a lovely guy. I was about to type no thanks, but my typing has gone all off as well here. Oh no. F5. Well, if you'll notice here, my illustrious opponent is making one or two weakening moves. And I'm going to try and come back and punish him for that later in the game. So let's get this h-pawn pushing down the board. If knight e5, maybe I can go h6 at an opportune moment. Maybe I can go queen d4. Whoops, maybe there'd be knight f3 check. So let's try not to blunder my queen here. It's one thing to blunder your queen, it's quite another thing to blunder your queen on a live broadcast. And another thing to do against an illustrious GM opponent who's played one G5 against you. I'm behind on the clock, and somehow I I don't seem to be better at all anymore. Well, almost tempted to offer him the draw back here and see if he wants to take it, but you know, I suspect I'll get ignored, or worse, he'll reply. What, he's just offered me he's offered me a draw. Well, my position's so bad, I can't not take it. I mean, what? I don't know why he's offering it. Right, Simon, I'm gonna give you two more games. And after that, I think I'm gonna need to take a break after that. Well, okay, let's play a Sicilian, because he knows that I play the French, and I'm sure he's going to play some kind of funky thing. And here we see it. Here we see his 2a3 defense. And again, I'm going to ignore the fact that he's probably trying to sacrifice a pawn. Well, okay, and then he's so determined to sacrifice a pawn that I'm going to grab it. You know what? I kind of think that he knows it's called hack attack. I mean, I'm friends with Simon. He'll be following me on Twitter. He'll be following me on Facebook. He'll know that I'm broadcasting hack attack right now. So he's obviously decided he fancies a little bit of fun, and he's obviously attempting to hack me up in some games. And that's kind of scary, because if you've ever seen Simon play in slow play in any kind of chess, he hacks up phenomenally strong players. He's beaten like a dozen 2600 players. He's really, really dangerous, and you don't want to be on the wrong side of Simon in a complicated position. And I'm waffling again and not playing moves quickly. I'm trying very much to encourage Simon to just recapture his pawn, and there we go, he's done that. And then actually I'm just gonna grab a pawn again, because I'm actually not liking my position that much, and so I'm gonna grab it back. Because like I said earlier, if you don't like your position, it's better to be material up here. But I have a really bad feeling about this position, and no, it's not just because I'm playing a grandmaster. Although that does influence it a little bit. It's amazing how a position that you would go, yeah, I'm a pawn up, but my opponent's got a bit of counterplay, it turns into, wow, you know, I've got to play every move absolutely perfectly, keep everything 100% under control. And the reason for that is because I know that my opponent is capable of punishing a single mistake just because of his tactical ability. For example, here, maybe he can take on c5 and play knight c7 and embarrass my pieces. And as soon as I say that, immediately he takes on c5 and plays knight c7. So there we see an example. Surely he's not just taking me a draw again. No, he's going to play knight c7 again, and then he's going to improve the second time round with something like knight a6. I'm not certain what his improvement is, but Simon, if you can hear me, I'm sure that you're not going to play knight b5 and offer me a draw. I know that you're not going to do that. Yeah. Yeah, you didn't fool me. I knew you were going to go for this. That doesn't mean that it makes my position any better. But it does at least mean... Why is he offering me a draw again? I actually don't know what Simon's doing here by offering me so many draws. I like his position.
That's my job.
But but so what? I don't care that he's better. You guys have not tuned in to see me agree a draw with a grandmaster in lots and lots of games. You've tuned in to see entertainment. So I'm sorry, Simon. If it was just you and me playing, I'd probably have taken your draw. But with these kind people watching, I think I have a duty to entertain. And just as well, because there is my extra exchange back. Thank you very much. And now I'm not going to take your draw. And this time, it's because I actually like my position. That's always a nice change. So what have we got here? We've actually got a position with equal material, but my opponent has doubled pawns, and I have these slightly more active looking pieces and also a nice active position here. So, and I'm up on the clock. So apologies, Simon, I'm also prepared to flag you. I would like to win the game through skill and technique in the face of a tricky ending, but you know, I'll take a flag any day of the week. Although this is now heading to a very, very drawish ending. So if we reach a completely dead drawn ending, I will offer a draw. But I'm going to put a little bit of pressure on just for a couple of moments, see if I can get my opponent to blunder a piece. I feel a bit bad about winning just on time. So I'm going to put pressure on until my opponent's down to a couple of seconds. If the position is still a draw, I will offer a draw. But of course, unless Simon is watching, he's resigned. Okay. Maybe he thought I was going to flag him. Interesting. Okay, right, I'm going to make this my last game for the time being. And then I'll just take a short break. So we're going to finish up this series against Ginger GM, also known as English Grandmaster Simon Williams. And, oh dear, I'm actually playing a rather dull variation against the French, against the Sicilian, but, Oh, he's playing some G5 line. Simon loves this G5 move, especially in all kinds of Sicilian positions. I'm just going to ignore him for the time being. I hope you guys are enjoying this, by the way. I know I'm enjoying getting to broadcast this match against a GM on Twitch TV. I hear we're up to more than 40 viewers now, which is excellent. Again, my opponent was trying to sacrifice some material, but I have ignored that. Oh, I'm struggling for a plan again. If I castle kingside, I know he's going to do something, so I'm not going to do that. What I want to do is get a big attack myself. You know, I'm just going to tuck my king on f1. You know, it's annoying not to be able to castle, but actually, for the time being, my king's relatively safe on this square, and it allows me to just carry on developing, and maybe I will be the one to get some cheapo threats in here. A6, I'll give a little check, expecting bishop d7, and I will drop the queen back to a3. Big plan of rook e1 here, targeting his weak e7 square. And again, this game feels like, for the time being, it is going quite well. And I know Simon is looking for something aggressive to do, but I have a few threats, so it's not so easy for him here. And queen f6, I spotted that move a minute ago, but I think just bishop g5 is a very strong response here. Oh, he's got queen there. Well, this is a little bit disappointing. I probably had a better move. Probably rook e1 before was a better way of playing it, but this still must be very, very strong for me. I mean, look, this knight on d5 is a very good piece, and there's no good threat, good defense to knight c7 check, which is why he's played this. Now the question is, do I have something better than grabbing an exchange? Is rook e1 check going to get me anywhere? Is bishop takes h7 going to get me anywhere? Let's just give knight c7 check a go and see where he puts his king. If he goes king f7, I've also got bishop c4 at some moment, or I could drop the bishop back to f4, or I could take the rook off straight away. I've got lots of good options here. And I'm just going to retreat the bishop back. I don't want this game to be complicated. As usual, I'm panicking because what I actually need to be doing is calculating here, and the one thing that I don't have time to do is calculate. But hopefully I'm forcing his king forward, and I've got his king close to into some kind of mating net here. And oh, and that's going to be mate, and the king has to go back to h6, and then knight f5 is mate. Ooh, and there we go.